we're going to begin by heating up about 5 cups of water. And today I'll be using jasmine rice. Of course, y'all know that is my favorite rice. And here I have 2 cups of jasmine rice. I'm going to go ahead and wash it until the water runs clear because I want to get out as much starch as possible. Once it's washed, I'm going to go ahead and add it into the water. While I do that, let me say hello to you all. Hello, sweet team. Welcome back to my channel. This is Sweet Ajele. I am so excited to be with you all today, and I hope everyone is doing wonderfully well. I am doing just fine. Then add in some salt to taste. It is optional, but it serves as a preservative, especially if you're not keeping your omotsu in the refrigerator. Give it a quick stir, cover it up, and bring it to a boil. Once it boils, you want to lower your heat to low and allow it to cook slowly until the rice is ready, and by then it'll be nice and soft for us to make our rice balls. So this rice cooked for about 20 minutes and I'm back to check on it. I cooked it under pressure, so it was quick, but I just left it alone to do its thing. You wanna go ahead and check it to see how soft it is. If it is nice and soft, then we are ready to mash it up. So I begin by pushing everything into the middle because the bottom part of the rice is always softer than the top. And if you begin pressing it to the side of your pot immediately, some of it may fall out and we don't want that. So once we've mixed everything beautifully like this, as you can see, the bottom part is softer, so our rice is already beginning to look soft. So at this point, I'm going to go ahead and begin pressing it to the side of the pot, but I do that carefully by tilting the pot every time I bring it to the side until everything comes together and I know it's not gonna fall out. Remember, our rice is already cooked. All we're doing now is mashing it up to make it nice and soft in order for us to make it into our balls. So that is all I'm doing, kind of like the way we make bangkun, only this time we're using rice. Now let me tell you, weekends are for omotsu in Ghana. This is a hit in Ghana every weekend, especially for my husband and I. Whenever we're in Ghana, we do not miss omotsu on the weekend at our favorite spot, Mauli. So if you haven't tried omotsu, just watch and learn this super easy recipe that Ghanaians go crazy for. Now, some people like it grainy, others like it soft, but I like it perfectly in between. So you may mash this until it is at your preference, and mine is there now. So all I'm doing is smoothening the top because I am ready to make it into my balls. So you need a scoop like this, and you want to scoop the amount or size that you like. Roll it up and keep it in your choice hydro or food flask. You can also keep it in your cooler. Repeat the process until everything is nicely rolled up. You can also wrap it individually in a food safe plastic wrap. The one that I'm using is food grade. You may use it or not. It's totally optional, okay? But I've given you 2 options, either this or the other way. Now we wrap it because we do not want it to dry out. Once it dries out, it'll no longer be yummy, and we do not want that. We want to enjoy this yumminess. And there you have it, our rice balls, aka omotsu, is ready. You may serve this with either palm nut soup or peanut butter soup, with a little bit of beans, just as I'm doing, and also topping it with my goat meat peanut butter / groundnut soup. Oh my goodness, this soup was absolutely delicious, but unfortunately I lost parts of the clips in the video. But don't worry, I'll make another video just for you, so do stay tuned. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and are inspired to try the recipe. Sweet team, y'all know I love you. Until I see you in the next video, stay safe, keep loving each other, and remember that the love of God and family is life's greatest blessing. And guys, ke onamini uchemi sweet mahabutu. Bye y'all.